Right before we start this video, I just want to give a shout out to Iris Games for sending me a power supply. If you guys want to get your own power supply or you guys are looking to build a PC, they have a bunch of CPU coolers, power supplies, and a bunch more stuff like that on their website. I'll put the link down in the description. They sent me a power supply. I'm going to be building my brother a PC soon, and this is an absolutely great PC. It's a 500 watt. This is a bronze. So thank you so much for sending me this, guys. Like I said, this is going to my brother's PC. And yeah, let's hop into the video. Yo, what is going on YouTube? My name is Sneaky. Welcome back to another Warzone how-to video. Today I'm here bringing you guys the Naga skin. If you guys haven't noticed, season 2 just dropped here in Warzone, and there's a lot of people that are immediately going to start going to my channel trying to figure out or get a little bit of a better understanding of the operator missions here on these skins. So if you guys don't know, if you haven't seen my content before, one of the main things I do here on the channel is I go through the skins and I kind of teach people that are new to the game how to unlock the different versions of the skin. So I've done this for every single Battle Pass skin all the way through since season 1. So if you guys have any of those skins and you want to learn how to get any of the operators, make sure to go check out some of my old videos. I should have a playlist made where I have just a section of all the skin videos I've made. But yeah, if you guys are also new, please hit that subscribe button, because we are on our way to 4,000 subscribers. I have a couple friends that are already at that 4K mark, and I'm trying to catch up to them and trying to beat them. We have like a friendly competition going. So if you guys can help me win, help me get up there, please hit that sub button. Also like that video. And if you guys have any questions, if I didn't hit a certain topic in here and you guys have any questions, make sure to go down into the comments section below and ask me, and I should be able to help you guys out with the skin problems. But yeah, right before we get into this, one more thing. I stream on Twitch almost every single day, doing viewer games, answering questions about the skins, doing giveaways, tournaments, everything like that. I'm currently ranked top 500 in Warzone right now, so if you guys want to see kind of a good player play at the game, or learn anything, or ask me any questions, anything like that, then make sure to hop in my stream. It'll be the top link in the description below. So there's two ways to access the skin challenges. You can go all the way to the beginning of the battle pass and click F, or whatever button it tells you to click right up here. So you're gonna click that and it's gonna pull up the operator missions here, just like this. Or if you're currently not in season 2 watching this video, but you still wanna learn how to unlock the skins and you already bought the battle pass before, you go to operators and you're just gonna find the skin in the operators right here, as you can see. And then we're gonna click right here. You can see operator missions. It tells you what to click, so you can view the missions. For me, it's 2. So I'm gonna click that and it's gonna pull up the same thing it would have pulled up over in the battle pass. So here is the very first operator mission. As you guys can see, this one right here, Blood Money, is currently for the tier 100 skin. So if you guys aren't 100% sure what that means, Warzone makes a tier 1 skin, so right when you buy the battle pass, you get a new character, and then there's a bunch of characters in between and stuff that aren't very good, and then there's a tier 100 skin that's supposed to be really good and better than all of them. So that's kind of how they work it. This is the tier 100 skin, so once you hit tier 100 in the battle pass, you unlock this lock will turn into a box shape, and then you're able to grind all these challenges. I'll still go through it, like I said, later on in the video, if you're here for that. So we're gonna go ahead and hop into the tier 1 skin here. There is 4 objectives that you have to do to get all of the skins for the tier 1. I'm currently at objective 1 because it came out last night. I haven't really been able to grind it yet. But yeah, objective 1, it just says get 15 kills with any weapon dropped by an enemy. So basically, the way that's gonna have to work is I'm assuming you're gonna have to kill an enemy, pick up their guns, and kill more enemies with it. So you basically just need to get kills with other people's weapons, is what it's saying. I get a lot of questions, people asking me, what game modes can you do the skin challenges in? You can do the skin challenges in any game mode, except when it tells you you have to do it in a certain game mode at the end of the text. So for example, this one right here, you could do this in Cold War multiplayer. You could 100% do this in Cold War multiplayer, hop into a multiplayer game, kill a person, pick up their gun, and go get more kills. You could do that. In Warzone, same thing, kill a person, pick up their guns, go get more kills. It doesn't say you have to do it in a certain one. If it said in Warzone here, then you couldn't do it in Cold War. You would have to only do it in Warzone. So once you get 15 kills with weapons dropped by enemies, you will unlock 1500 XP, and you will unlock this really cool. So basically all this is saying is you literally just need to get 5 kills with a Molly. So in Warzone, you grab the Molly nade and you just throw it at somebody and you gotta kill them with it. Do that 5 times. If you have Cold War, this would honestly be better in Cold War. I would go to your weapons in Cold War, find the lethals, and select Molly for it. I'm not exactly sure if there's a Molly in Cold War. I personally do not play Cold War. If there is a Molly in Cold War, then you need to use the Molly. Then all you gotta do is get 5 kills with it, and then you should be good. So I'm gonna go ahead and go back over to objective 2. Yep, so get 5 kills with a Molly. Could be in Cold War. If there's Mollies in Cold War, I'm not 100% sure. Or get 5 kills with Mollies in Warzone. So go ahead and choose any game mode you want. Just get 5 kills with a Molly. So once you complete that, you'll get 2000 XP and this really cool skin. This is the very first second skin. So if you're not familiar with how Warzone does it, Warzone usually gets a main character, then a second version of it, and then a third version of it. This is the second version, so this is like the halfway point before the final skin, the middle point between the final skin and the very first one. So yeah, this is the second one. It's a really cool blue and red and purple color. This thing is actually super freaking cool. I'm excited to use this whenever I unlock it. It's freaking bright, dude. That's the only thing. I think maybe it might be a lot easier for people to see you. But other than that, it is freaking awesome. So the skin is actually a pretty cool one. So then once you're at objective 3, it tells you to replenish ammo 25 times using the scavenger perk. So all this is basically saying if you're in Cold War, all you gotta do is kill enemies and I guess run over their bodies 25 times and get a bunch more ammo with the scavenger perk. And that should complete the objective for you. If you're in Warzone, you need to equip the scavenger perk, go kill people and run over their bodies, and it will do the exact same thing. And like I'm saying, guys, if you guys don't see the skin in your front page right here, it's not equipped it. So you guys got to go to your operators and you got to make sure you select the skin to use it here. I don't know why it is currently using that. Okay, boom. So yeah, if it's selected here, it will work. That's all you guys need to know. If it is selected here and you go into a game with it, it will count towards those points. If you have a different operator selected, it will go towards that operator points. So make sure you have the operator select that you're wanting to upgrade. And also, whenever I say Warzone, I'm speaking of Plunder and the mini Warzone as well. I'm talking about all of the Warzone game modes, so keep that in mind. I just like to say Warzone instead of Plunder. But yeah, once you complete this, you will get 2500 XP, and you will get a really cool snake emblem, which freaking looks sick. Then it will take you to objective 4 out of 4. So for this, all you gotta do is knife 5 different people in the game. And you get the skin, which I think is crazy easy. It says combat knife, which is weird because if you go over here to the weapons, the modern warfare is called the combat knife, but then there's also the knife. I'm assuming because this is a Cold War skin, it's going to want you to use this knife. So I would recommend using this knife right off the start. Sorry, I just hit my mic. But yeah, I recommend using this knife off the start. And seeing it starts counting as your kills. If it doesn't count as your kills, then it's definitely going to be this knife. But I'm 100% assuming it's this knife right here, the Cold War knife. They'd be silly to do any other knife because then you wouldn't be able to do it in Cold War. So make sure to use the Cold War knife, not the Modern Warfare knife. Unless it's the other way around, I'm not 100% sure, but just try both the knives. Also, I'm a little stuffed up if you guys can't tell, so I'm sorry. That's why my voice sounds a little weird. But yeah, so once you do that, once you get 5 knife kills, you'll be completed with the entire tier 1 challenges, and you guys will get 3000 XP, and you will unlock the final skin for tier 1, which is a complete white suit. If Warzone ever makes a snow map, this is going to be one of the best characters ever. I'm not even kidding. If Warzone released a super snowy part of a map where all the trees are covered in snow, the ground, obviously all the houses, just a super snowy part, this skin is going to be so good because it is going to be the Rook skin of the snow. It is just freaking all like white and then a little bit of black in there, but the skin is bright white. So this is perfect for a snow map if Warzone ever releases one. And overall, it's just a freaking awesome skin. So it is definitely worth grinding for, in my opinion. Alright, so now it is time to run through the tier 100 skin. I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how you guys can access it. You guys can go through the battle pass, go all the way to the tier 100, and if you guys have hit tier 100 and you've unlocked it, you can go through and do the operator mission. So we're going to go ahead and click F here on the operator, and it's going to pull us up, and it's going to be the Blood Money Objective 4. I don't know why it says Objective 4. I think that just means it has 4 objectives. But yeah, so basically, you're going to go through all of the objectives here. I'm going to read through them here in a second. But another way you can get to the skin is if you go to the operators and you just go to Naga here. This will be the profile picture. You'll click 2 on it or whatever it tells you to click right here, and it will pull up the second version of it. Something I'm not really 100% sure why they do, but the tier 100 skin and the tier 1 skin are the exact same character. So if you guys want to ever find those skins, come over here and it should tell you what to click for customize. You'll click that and it will pull up all the different skins, all of the lists of the tier 100 and the tier 1 here, and you can select through them if you've unlocked them and done the objectives. So yeah, let's go ahead and hop into those objectives now. Objective 1 here. So it wants you to get 5 kills with a frag grenade. So if you're in Warzone, you'd pick up a frag grenade off the ground or get your loadout drop and make sure you have a frag grenade in your loadout, obviously with the character selected, and you just need to get 5 kills with a frag grenade. I recommend doing this in a Plunder game because Plunder is a little lower skill level and it's easier to kind of just catch people AFK or something like that. Plunder, so you just got to kill 5 people with a nade, or if you're in Cold War, this is very easy. Just get a frag grenade and kill 5 people with it with the operator, and you will and you will complete objective one, and you will get 1500 XP and a really cool jungle looking calling card, which freaking all the calling cards this season have just been really good. So that's freaking great art. So we're gonna move to objective two now, and it says to destroy 5 enemy ground vehicles. So ground vehicles, right here it is classifying that, so right here it is informing you that you cannot blow up a heli. It has to be on the ground. So if you're in Warzone, I'd recommend getting like an RPG or something, finding an enemy in a car and blowing them up. You'll have to do that 5 different times if you're in Warzone. Or if you're in Cold War, all you got to do is find somebody on a snowmobile or a vehicle, anything like that, and blow them up, and that's it. And basically that will complete objective 2 for you, and make sure that you have the skin selected. Obviously a lot of people, they get upset when all this stuff isn't counting. Well, your skin might not be selected, and that's why you're not able to do it. So yeah, once you destroy 5 enemy vehicles, and I'm not 100% sure if you can shoot a vehicle after an enemy's got out of it, because I know sometimes in Warzone the car remains red out of after an enemy just got out of it for some reason. So I'm pretty sure you need to shoot an enemy out of the car as well. So keep that in mind. But yeah, you get 2000 XP once you complete it, and you get the second version of the tier 100 skin. So obviously there's a tier 100, the second version, and the third version. So yeah, here is the second one. He has kind of, this reminds me of like a watermelon face mask. I don't know why. This guy reminds me of kind of like a pirate. He's with like a watermelon face mask. So yeah, overall, I think it's a pretty funny skin, pretty cool. I think people that wear this are definitely going to be just the jokesters of the group, or just freaking the people that want to mess around and have fun. The skin is freaking hilarious in my opinion. I don't take this seriously at all. He's wearing like a rainbow hoodie. It's freaking hilarious. So that is the second objective. So we're going to move to the third one now. And the third objective is rapidly kill 2 or more enemies 3 times. So all this is saying is you need to hop in a game and get a double kill. Now this is kind of hard to do in Warzone sometimes, because you can't really just kill a guy and go straight to killing another guy. Warzone, it's a little harder. You know, if it's quads, that's probably the easiest, and plunder is probably going to be the easiest, but this is best in Cold War. All you got to do is get 2 or more kills really quickly. So like in one magazine, you shoot a dude and you move to your shot and you shoot another dude. That's basically what it is saying. You just got to get rapid kills, and you got to do that 3 times. So once you guys get 3 rapid kills, obviously 2 or more kills really quickly all in a row, kind of like a quad feed type of deal, then you will complete objective 3 out of 4, and you will get 2500 XP, and you guys will get this really cool tiger emblem, which anybody that has like a tiger logo that does YouTube, they will 100% be rocking this. This skin is sick. It's actually got gold armor now that I see it. Bro, this calling card is definitely super cool as well. So we're going to go to objective 4 out of 4. And all it says, all you got to do is execute 1 finishing move. So you just got to execute somebody. I'm pretty sure you could freaking do this in a pregame lobby if you wanted. I'm not 100% sure. But you could literally just hop in a game, find somebody running around, pop a dead silence, and you unlock the final skin. All you have to do is literally just finish somebody. You can do this in Warzone, Cold War, Plunder, it doesn't matter. That's all you gotta do is finish somebody, and you get 3000 XP and the final skin, the tier 100 skin, right, is the final skin. Then the second version, this is the third version of the tier 100 skin. He's got like a tiger face mask on him. He's got like a tiger robe. This skin is freaking, this skin's definitely a lot more serious than the other one. The other one was kind of funny since it had so many bright colors in it. So this is something I would actually rock. Like, this thing is actually pretty cool. So make sure to head over to the Twitch. I'll be live answering questions and everything like that every single evening, actually. So that is the video, guys. Thank y'all so much for watching. So yeah, that is how you guys unlock the skin. Make sure to go follow the Twitch. Make sure to sub to the YouTube channel. And yeah, thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Peace.